The key enzyme that is needed for glycogenesis, the building of glycogen molecules, is glycogen synthase. So this is the enzyme that basically catalyzes the formation of alpha-1-4 glycosidic bonds. It basically connects the glucose molecules within the glycogen. So it extends and elongates the glycogen polymer chain. Now, this enzyme is not only actually used to build up the glycogen chain, it is also actually used to control the rate at which glycogen synthesis actually takes place. So we can actually turn off the glycogen synthase enzyme, and that in turn turns off the process of glycogenesis. So once again, glycogen synthase catalyzes the elongation of glycogen. It attaches the glucose monomers by forming alpha-1-4 glycosidic bonds. But this important enzyme also happens to be a key regulatory protein in glycogenesis, in building the glycogen molecule. It helps control the rate of glycogen synthesis. So this enzyme glycogen synthase actually exists in two different forms. We have glycogen synthase A and glycogen synthase B. Now, the only difference between these two enzymes is the fact that glycogen synthase B is simply the phosphorylated version of glycogen synthase A. Now, glycogen synthase A always exists in the fully active form. Now, glycogen synthase B is predominantly in the inactive form, but under certain molecules, so certain molecules that we'll talk about in just a moment, can actually act as allosteric activators of glycogen synthase B. And by binding to glycogen synthase B, they can actually make it an active molecule. Now, to go from glycogen synthase E, the fully active molecule that basically stimulates glycogen synthesis, into glycogen synthase B, the inactive molecule, we have to actually use ATP molecules to phosphorylate glycogen synthase A. Now, glycogen synthase A contains several sites where phosphorylation can actually take place. And glycogen synthase A also basically responds to a number of different types of protein kinases. But two important protein kinases, which basically deactivate glycogen synthase A by phosphorylating it, are protein kinase A, PKA, and an enzyme known as glycogen synthase kinase, or GSK. More specifically, it's glycogen synthase kinase 3. So glycogen synthase is affected by several kinases and contains different phosphorylating sites. However, two very important kinases that are able to actually turn off glycogen synthase A are protein kinase A and glycogen synthase kinase. Now, remember that protein kinase A is actually stimulated by cyclic AMP. So if some type of signal transduction pathway takes place that increases the concentration of cyclic AMP within our cell, that in turn stimulates PKA. And one of the target proteins of PKA is glycogen synthase A. So upon the stimulation of PKA, that essentially promotes the transformation of glycogen synthase A into glycogen synthase B. In addition, we also have this other kinase, the glycogen synthase kinase, that also stimulates the transformation of glycogen synthase A into glycogen synthase B. Now, once we go from this enzyme to this enzyme exists predominantly in the inactive form. And what that means is glycogen synthesis will not take place when the enzyme is in this particular form. However, there is an allosteric activator molecule that can actually influence this to become much more active, and that is glucose-6-phosphate. So if inside our body we have a build, if inside our cell we have a buildup of glucose-6-phosphate molecules, what that means is we don't want to keep the glucose-6-phosphate in that state. We want to store them in some other form. That is, we want to form glycogen. And so when we have a buildup of glucose-6-phosphate, The glucose-6-phosphate can actually bind to a regulatory site on glycogen synthase B, and that will stimulate it. It will transform it into its active form. So glycogen synthase B in the active form, and in that particular case, glycogen synthase B in the active form will stimulate glycogen synthesis, just like glycogen synthase A always stimulates the process of glycogen formation.